Lizzy Birdsworth, she's been around from the very beginning. A friend to the women and a heart of gold. She's been attacked, betrayed, held hostage and almost thrown from the prison roof. But despite all this, she's always the character who always tries to shine bright through all the darkness. Let's take a look back at some of the best moments from the show with the top 10 Lizzy Birdsworth moments. Lizzy's drunken speech. All the way back in season 1, we all immediately fell in love with Liz. She was looking after the girls, trying her best to protect them all from evil Jax Holt. However, Liz was holding her own dark secret. Liz has always had trouble resisting the drink. In season 1, episode 4, Liz discovers Boomer making some homebrew. The women have all been writing speeches for an upcoming event that Miss Davidson has organised along with Derek Channing and has invited the important people along with the press to see firsthand the changes that she has made to Wentworth since being made governor. Liz struggles when it's her time to make her speech and she ends up drinking some of Boomer's home brew. Unfortunately, Liz ends up getting very drunk, and when it's time for her to make her speech in front of a horrified crowd, a drunken Liz causes a scene by telling the crowd that the women here, they've been sticking drugs up the kids' bums and then they overdose. During the scene, we also learn that Liz ended up in prison because she got drunk at her mother-in-law's party, drove a tractor, and then squished her. Oh dear, Liz. Liz and the steak knife. Back in season 2, Liz had finally got her parole. She was sent to a very rundown hostel and she was being harassed by some drunken guy who was living at the property. One day she comes home and this drunken guy has broken into her room, attacks Liz and steals her money. Liz is very upset and she's absolutely furious, and later in the episode, Liz has taken a steak knife from a restaurant to protect herself. After B escapes from the hospital, the police visit Liz to see if B has been in contact. They spot the steak knife on the side of the drawer and they ask Liz, "What is this?" Liz replies, "It's a steak knife, love." The police then ask her, "What's it doing here?" And Liz's response is, "Waiting for a steak?" Liz was always great with her little one-liners, but this is the one that stuck out with most fans, which everyone buckled over with laughter. Liz's breakdown in the shower. Towards the end of season 5, Liz was at breaking point. Sonia was mentally torturing Liz, making Liz paranoid, and she even lied to Liz by saying that she had murdered Detective Don Kaplan. Poor Liz had developed strong feelings for Don, but Sonia was clearly toying with Liz. Just when Liz couldn't take any more, Sonia tells Boomer that Liz was witness X. Now Boomer hates laggers, and Liz has lagged on Boomer in a previous season. So Boomer goes to confront Liz in the shower block and has a go at Liz and screams in her face until Liz cannot take any more, and Liz completely loses her mind. Poor Liz, she ends up screaming back at Boomer that she's fucked up, starts pulling her hair out, slapping herself in the face before collapsing onto the floor. Completely shocking Boomer, as Boomer was not expecting that from Liz. Poor Liz. Liz attempts suicide. In season 6, Liz was diagnosed with early onset dementia and was going through a very hard time with Sonia and also later on with Drago. After witnessing Drago bash a fellow prisoner in the shower block, Liz starts to get confused and can't cope with her illness anymore. Mari Winter offers Liz a way out with an overdose of heroin, telling Liz that if she injects herself, she will fall asleep and all her pain will go away. So Liz writes notes to all her children, and in a moving scene, Liz is about to inject herself with the fatal dose. But Kaz walks into the cell just in time and stops Liz from doing it. Liz breaks down and tells Kaz that she just wants to die. A very, very dark moment for our Liz. Liz forgets Frankie. quite recently in season 7, the fans were given a treat, as lovable, feisty character Frankie Doyle made a guest appearance to visit Liz in the prison. But not all is what it seemed. Boomer had told Frankie that Liz was on new medication and that she was getting better. But unfortunately, when Frankie comes in to visit Liz, Liz doesn't know who Frankie is. Frankie ends up shedding a tear, but she holds Liz's hand and tells her that it's okay. Fun fact, Nicole, who plays Frankie, was heavily pregnant while filming these scenes, and it's almost as if the writers didn't even try to hide it during filming. Let's hope we get to see a bit more of Frankie in the new season. Liz saves Sophie. Back to season 2, while Liz is on parole, Liz is desperate to make contact with her children. One afternoon, Liz is sitting on a bench opposite her children's home and spots her daughter Sophie going on a night out with friends. Liz follows Sophie on the night out, and while Sophie is having drinks with her friends, Liz orders herself some food. This is where the steak knife came from. Later on, Sophie gets drunk and leaves the bar with a guy. So Liz follows them and spots the guy trying to force himself on Sophie. Liz runs over and pushes the guy over. At this point, Sophie is paralytic, but Liz helps get Sophie to a taxi. And just as the taxi drives off, Sophie opens her eyes and realizes that it's her mum who has just saved her. And she calls out to her mum while the taxi is driving off. Quite a moving moment for Liz. Liz witnesses Cherry's bashing. We are back onto some dark moments now in season 6. Liz is alone in the shower block and goes to take a shower. It isn't until she turns on the shower she realizes that she still has her clothes on and she's getting wet. Liz starts to giggle with the audience giggling with her, but the giggles soon turn to tears when Liz starts to realize that the dementia really has got a hold on her. A fellow prisoner, Cherry, comes in to take a shower, but she doesn't notice that Liz is in one of the cubicles sitting down. Then in comes Zara Dragovic, who viciously and brutally attacks Cherry when she thinks that Cherry has been lying to the police about Mari. Drago beats and beats Cherry on the floor, and it's at this moment Cherry spots Liz on the other side of the shower cubicle and tries to reach out for help before falling unconscious. Liz is helpless because if she makes a noise, Drago will probably do the same for her. Nasty times. Liz is ambushed. Things don't seem to be getting any better for Liz when Sonia tries her best to get Liz killed, but without getting her hands dirty. Sonia holds a radio interview broadcast and she invites along Liz. But Sonia purposely lets slip over the radio that Liz was witness X and the whole prison is listening. So now Sonia has outed Liz as a lagger to all the women and Liz is in serious danger. Kaz is doing her best to look after Liz, but Sonia manages to get Liz on her own, and she takes Liz out for a walk in the yard. Out in the yard, Sonia throws Liz to all the women and tells the women to show Liz what we all do to laggers. Kaz, Ali and Ruby desperately search for Liz, and when they can't find her in the cells, they find her in the yard being tormented and attacked by all the women. The women throw in mud and stones at poor Liz. Luckily, Kaz gets there just in time to save Liz. Not an easy scene to watch. Liz versus Sonia on the roof. When is poor Liz going to catch a break? After Sonia's plan of outing Liz fails to get rid of her, the next step is to get rid of her herself. So when Sonia thinks she has a chance of having all her charges dropped, Liz manages to record Sonia admitting to the murder of Sharon earlier on in the season. And Liz gives it to the police, meaning that Sonia is now looking at spending the rest of her life in Wentworth. Sonia is proper mad and decides that she is going to kill Liz once and for all. Workmen have been on the roof of the prison trying to fix the heating system. Liz starts to think that Don is one of the workmen on the roof, so Liz sneaks up onto the roof looking for him. Unfortunately, Sonia is right behind her and a showdown takes place. Sonia tries to smash in Liz's head with a wrench and also tries to throw it off the roof. Luckily for Liz, Kaz saves the day by pushing a deranged Sonia off the roof, ridding Liz of Sonia once and for all. Liz's death. Of course, as heartbreaking as this scene was to watch, it was always going to make the number one spot. Liz's dementia was getting worse, and after a traumatic siege and the effort of helping to deliver Vera's baby, Liz's health takes a turn for the worse, and she suffers a severe stroke, leaving Liz in a state of locked-in syndrome. Dr. Miller tells Boomer that Liz can hear everything that's going on around her, but she can no longer communicate and will have to stay in the psych ward to have full-time care. Earlier in the season, Liz had asked Boomer that when things get too much for her, she wants Boomer to help her die. Boomer has always said no, and even when Boomer visits Liz after her stroke, she says that she's not ready for the end yet. But Boomer sacrifices her freedom to help Liz. Boomer and Liz might have had their ups and downs in the past, but Boomer absolutely loves Liz and sees Liz as a second mum. And Boomer ends Liz's suffering in a seriously emotional scene that had everyone around the world in tears. A very, very sad end for Liz, but she is now at peace, and we all must thank Celia Ireland for her extraordinary performance over the last 7 years as Lizzie Birdsworth. So that was the top 10 moments of Lizzie Birdsworth. Do you agree with my list? Was there anything that I missed out? Let me know in the comments box below if I did, and I might make a part 2. Thank you for watching, guys, and I shall see you soon.